You know, after sight loss, one of the things that can happen to you is you can experience loneliness. I think a lot of people experience loneliness, but sight loss can be one of those catalysts to bring loneliness on. However, I think there's a myth that people talk about with loneliness, and I want to share that with you today. What's up, VIPs? Derek here, back with another video. And yes, I think that many people experience loneliness. However, I think that people perpetrate a myth on people that are lonely, and that myth simply says, hey, if you just get out more, if you just meet more people, if you just go to more parties and go to more things and have more friends, you won't be lonely anymore. However, I actually think that can be a myth. By the way, if you're new around here, my name is Derek and I help people just like you to discover life after sight loss. Here we do product reviews, life advice, encouragement, how-tos, and so much more. So if all that sounds good to you, I'd love for you to consider subscribing to the channel and turning on notifications so you don't miss another single video. Now, why do I think that's a myth? The idea that going out and meeting new people will not necessarily mean loneliness is over. Well, here's the thing. I've talked about this before, but it reminded me because I did a podcast episode recently, which I'll link down in the description box, talking about what happens when you're the only VIP in your life. You know, when you don't have any other people that are visually impaired, you're just surrounded by a sea of sighted people, which, again, isn't necessarily a bad thing. However, some things can happen, and loneliness is one of those things. But I'm a social person. I love going out and meeting new people. I'll go and have a coffee with somebody or hanging out at the mall with some friends or like I'm, you know, a teenager or something. You know, going out with my family, whatever. I love doing that and I love being social. However, even in some of those social moments, I can still feel very lonely. Why? Well, it's because for me, and this isn't the only reason, but for me, I'm experiencing that moment way differently than all the rest of the people that are with me. Let's say, for example, we're going to a baseball game, okay? So we're gonna go to a baseball game, we're gonna have a good time, we're gonna eat a hot dog that's suspect at best, we're gonna drink a lot of soda, eat a lot of popcorn, cheer for our favorite team, we're gonna have a great time, you know, spend time with family, friends, whatever, it's a great outing. However, I'm experiencing that whole game way differently than they are. You know, my family might be cheering when somebody hits the ball or makes a great catch or something like that. However, I'm way behind the curve and somebody has to explain what's going on to me. And that can make me feel like, oh, they gotta explain this. This is such a burden. And well, it's not even enjoyable because they're clapping and I don't know why they're clapping. And then what ends up happening is I focus on the things I can do, like eating those suspect hot dogs. And then I eat 3 or 4 and that's not good for me. You know, and then I get depressed because I've eaten 3 or 4 hot dogs, and then I feel alone again because nobody understands me, and it's a vicious cycle. So the myth of just go out and be with more people, you know, that'll mean you're not lonely. That's a myth. Now, am I saying you shouldn't go out? No. I'm saying you should go out 100%. Yes, go, have fun, enjoy all the people you can. That's a wonderful thing. But don't do it solely based on the fact that you won't be lonely anymore. Oh, I'll just hang out with friends every day, all day, and I'll avoid loneliness. I think that's like running from a lion and hoping that you're gonna outrun him. You know, like you're just running really hard and all of a sudden you're like, you look back and boom, he's right behind you because you can't outrun him. You just can't. Loneliness will catch up with you eventually. It might catch up with you when you're all alone at home, or it might catch up with you when you're out with a bunch of friends. Now, again, let me just clarify something. I'm not saying don't go out with friends. And I'm not saying you can't escape loneliness and you're going to be sad and lonely the rest of your life. What I'm suggesting here is this. When you're experiencing those lonely moments, those moments when you're all by yourself and you're feeling so alone, when you're experiencing those lonely moments and you're in a big group of people, first of all, remember, this is normal. This is normal, doesn't matter who you're with or if you're by yourself or whatever. This is totally normal. We're experiencing life a little bit differently, and that's okay. It's hard, sure, but it's normal. And secondly, tell yourself this, I am not alone. One, because maybe you have all those friends and family with you. Yes, they're experiencing things differently, and I get it, but remember, you're not alone. And secondly, you're not alone because there's people out there just like me, just like you, that understand what it's like to be visually impaired. Yeah, I might be on the other side of this camera, on the other side of the screen, talking to you right now, but I understand what you're going through. Maybe not exactly what you're going through, because maybe our sight level's different, our life is different, you know, things like that, but I get what it means to be visually impaired and experience life through the eyes of a VIP. And there are many, many, many other people who experience life like that every single day. So the next time you're feeling lonely, even if you're with a bunch of people, remember, this is totally normal. And tell yourself, you know what? I'm really, really not alone. So my question for you today is this. Do you guys experience loneliness? Do you experience it when you're by yourself, when you're with a big group of people? When do you experience it? And how do you deal with it? I'd love to hear about it, and I'm sure others would as well. So let me know in the comments below. Hey, if you like this video, if you found it helpful, well, make sure to show your support by giving it a big thumbs up and sharing it out with somebody that you know. And if you are new around here and you like this stuff, well, make sure you hit that subscribe button and ring that bell so you don't miss another single video. Thanks so much for watching wherever you are. And until next time, remember that sight loss isn't the end. It's just the beginning. My name's Derek Daniel from LifeAfterSightLoss.com, and I'll see you in the next one.